There's been a couple of videos now working with the modulation and effect sections of instrument creation. And some important differences between those sections were only briefly touched on. So it'd be a good idea to spend a few minutes looking at those differences, since they're not immediately obvious. In a Renoise instrument, modulation is applied polyphonically, while effects are not. But what exactly does this mean? In the modulation section, each note played is tracked independently on the timeline of the envelope. Each note retains its individual value and trajectory, even if what's displayed on the envelope view is altered by the device chain or future notes. And this is important to keep in mind. The envelope shown here at any time is not necessarily the path that all notes are following. In the effects section, any changes occurring within an effects chain are applied to the audio currently playing through it. There is no distinction for separate notes. And you're probably familiar with this, since this is how it's always worked with track effects. And as you'd expect, altering the devices of an effects chain via macros works in the same way. However, something you need to be aware of is that changes to modulation devices via macros will, in the same way, update all currently playing notes in real time. So, to clarify, envelope changes made by the modulation devices are handled polyphonically, while changes made to the devices by macros are not. This means that macros can provide you with a huge amount of control over the behaviour of an instrument by simply turning a controller. But there is a trade-off, since this does mean that if, for example, you were hoping to dynamically adjust the length of an AHDSR's release parameter on a per-note basis, then I'm afraid that's just not possible. Although, the instrument construction possibilities of Renoise are powerful enough that you could craft such an idea by setting up multiple samples, key zones, and modulation sets.